Mr. President, I rise to come to the floor tonight to talk about something I'd like to see done in the United States Senate, the passage of the Land and Water Conservation Fund. Definitely, the Senate has and Congress disappointed us in not passing the Export-Import Bank, something I'm a big proponent of, and now here we are with the Land and Water Conservation Fund. For the first time in 51 years since this program has been created, it has expired. My colleagues are here on the floor to join me, the senator from Montana and the senator from New Mexico, to talk about why this is such a vital program to all of our states and why we should have it reauthorized immediately. The bill creating the Land and Water Conservation Fund was championed by Senator Scoop Jackson at the request of then-President Kennedy. Why? Because the American population was growing. There was a need for outdoor recreation, open space, and public lands. And the Land and Water Conservation Fund was created to help and protect some of our most popular national parks, forests, public lands, and iconic places. So for me, this is an incredibly important program because it's provided opportunities for hunting, for fishing, for hiking, and recreational uses that so many people use when traveling to the Pacific Northwest for vacation or just livelihood on public lands. Those of us who are from states with large amount of public lands recognize the importance of outdoor recreation, and nationwide outdoor recreation supports more than 6 million jobs. This is an economy in and of itself. In the state of Washington, outdoor recreation contributes more than $11 billion annually to our economy, and it's clear that protecting our public lands is good both for our environment and our economy. The Conservation Fund has credited each year with funds from the Outer Continental Shelf and gas and oil revenues, and the success of that program has helped us authorize and spend for these investments on behalf of the American people, as I said, for more than 50 years. So we're here to remind our colleagues that we're going to put up a fight until we get the Conservation Fund reauthorized and to make sure that people in our states and all across the nation that enjoy public lands have access to them. The issue is important to us, and in the energy bill passed out of the Senate Energy Committee, I worked with my colleague, Senator Murkowski, on a bipartisan basis to include a permanent reauthorization of the Land and Water Conservation Fund in our bipartisan energy bill. And it was, I was joined by 31 senators when we introduced the American Energy and Innovation Act that also permanently reauthorized the Land and Water Conservation Fund. So you can see from these two pieces of legislation that there is a lot of support by our colleagues for making sure that this vital program that is used by cities, by counties, by jurisdictions all throughout my state and many other across the nation, that this is a vital tool for helping us continue to thrive in our outdoor economy. We want to see this legislation reauthorized as soon as possible. And I thank my colleagues again from New Mexico and Montana for being here and for their leadership on this issue.